currently we're serving over 3,200 individuals a week. Last month it was 3,000, the month before was 2,500.
For the last year, the Fort York Food Bank has seen a month-over-month increase in people needing help, demand that its executive director says has been mainly fueled by inflation.
We see everyone from students to the elderly, definitely a lot of working families, individuals, those on Ontario Disability or Ontario Works.
Surging demand captured in this video posted to Twitter earlier this week. A long lineup outside the food bank on College Street.
We deliver primarily food, but food and other essential items to people who need it in the city of Toronto by bicycle.
Bike Brigade is a network of volunteer cyclists delivering food and other essentials to those in need. The group, which was launched during the pandemic, works with a number of community-based organizations, including the Fort York Food Bank.
I probably average 3 pickup locations a day and about 6 deliveries a day. People have challenges, people have struggles. If I can help in a little way like this, like, it's meaningful.
The Daily Bread Food Bank has also seen demand rise exponentially.
Just how dire have things become? Well, consider this. The Daily Bread now spends between $1.5 and $1.8 million on food alone. That used to be its yearly spend.
2023 is shaping up to be the worst year that the Daily Bread Food Bank and each of the food banks all across the city have ever experienced before.
CEO Neil Hetherington tells Global News that prior to the pandemic, they saw about 60 to 65,000 clients per month. That doubled to 120,000 during the pandemic.
And now this past March, we saw 270,000 client visits.
Hetherington tells us one-third of food bank users have full-time employment, yet can't make ends meet.
We need to fundamentally ask, why is that the case, and implement the solutions to that.
Shallima Maharaj, Global News.